All right, everybody, welcome to today's episode. Let me take that out of my mouth so y'all can understand what I'm saying. Welcome to today's episode of the shit you missed today. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Let me know what you think. Like, comment, and subscribe. Oh my goodness, I'm sorry, y'all. I gotta move around. I'm trying to get comfortable. Like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you think. We have five.
I made a mistake. We actually have four.
So, let's get started. Let me connect to properly to the right Wi-Fi. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna start all over. Hold on, y'all. I'm gonna have to start all over. Oh, no, I don't. I don't gotta start all over. Okay. It can still record me. So let me do this. Okay, do that. I gotta sign into another network because I can't be on the same network. I don't feel comfortable with doing that. So I have to be on two different networks to make these videos. You feel me? So yeah, we do have five topics today. If you're out and about, please be careful outside if there is snow in your area because it's slippery and wet outside, and people do not know how to drive, okay? They don't know how to drive. They just simply don't know how to drive at all. So, what is this? Okay, we'll never worry about that. So let's get started. Our first topic is about a girl group. One of the girl groups. I know you do it. Yes, no, maybe so. Maybe. I know you do it. Okay. See, it went to the wrong one. It went to the wrong one. Okay, let me try it again. Alright. This is taking way longer than I expected. Okay, this says Irani spectator who brought edge to girl group sound dies at 78. May she rest in peace. My condolences go out to her family. Actually, I got three deaths to talk about today, but she is the first one we're going to talk about. Let's read and see what's going on. It says, Ronnie Spectator, who brought edge to girl group sound, dies at 78. Ronnie Spectator, the lead singer of the Ronettes, the 1960s. It said I gotta subscribe. I'm not subscribing. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to take a screenshot and get as much as I can, as well as I can, and read what I got. Okay. So I'm gonna read just what I got because it's telling me subscribe and I'm not subscribing. Ronettes, the 1960 vocal trio that gave a passionate bad girl edge to the pop girl group sound with hits like Be My Baby and Baby I Love You, died on Wednesday. She was 78 years old. She died after a brief battle with cancer, according to a statement from her family, which gave no further details. Wow. With high-piled hair, tight outfits, and seductive looks, the three young women of the Ronettes, Ronnie Bourne, Veronica Bennett, her sister Estelle, and their cousin Nidra Tally transformed the virginal model that had defined female pop groups since the 1940s. We weren't afraid to be hot. That was our gimmick, Miss Spectator wrote in her 1990 memoir, Be My Baby. How I should buy mascara, miniskirts, and madness, or my life as a fabulous brunette. When she saw the Shirley's walk on stage with their wide party dresses, she wrote, "We went to the opposite direction and squeezed our bodies in the tightest skirts we can find. Then we got on stage and hiked them up to show our legs even more." So that's all I got because it won't let me read anymore because you have to subscribe. And I got this article on NewYorkTimes.com. So if you want to read more about it or you want to subscribe to their newspaper articles, you can go on NewYorkTimes.com and read more information about it. Condolences to the family, and may she rest in peace, lay in power, and never be disturbed in her grave. Moving on to the next topic. The next topic is, this might be good for some women. You know, some women might, but it's, I feel like it's good all the way around because they probably shouldn't even be locked up from the beginning, but what do I know? Thousands of federal inmates being released this week under laws signed by Trump. Even though Biden out here reversing laws that Trump passed, but they still got a law that they still have laws. I can't even say it right. I ain't making no sense. So just let me read you what the article say. This article is on sharenewsbreak.com. It says, thousands of federal inmates will be released this week in accordance with the law signed by former President Trump in 2018. The Department of Justice announced on Thursday that a new rule has been submitted to the Federal Register to begin applying a time credits program that was put forth in the First Step Act, which Trump signed in 2018. The law allows eligible inmates to earn between 10 and 50 days of time credits. For every 30 days that they participate in evidence-based reduction program and productive activities. Programs include anger management, drug treatment, education, and class focused on work and social skills, according to Associated Press. Up to 12 months of credit can be applied to supervised release at the discretion of the Bureau of Prison, BOP director, according to the DOJ, and they can be used retroactively from December 28, 2018, which was the day Trump signed the bill into law, subject to the BOP's determination of eligibility. Credits earned can be used to receive an earlier placement in pre-release custody. The program will be implemented on a rolling basis, according to the DOJ. Inmates who have time credits that exceed the remaining days in custody will be released first. The DOJ said thousands of inmates will be affected by the new rule, according to the AP. The First Step Act, a critical piece of bipartisan legislation, promised a path an earlier return home for eligible incarcerated people who invested their time and energy in programs that reduce Attorney General Merrick Garland said in a statement, today, the Department of Justice is doing its part to honor the promise and is pleased to implement these important programs, he added. News of the new rule began submitted comes roughly 2 months after the DOJ Inspector General found that the BOP did not award credit to about 60,000 inmates who have finished programs to reduce, I don't even know how to say that word, because the procedures were not finalized and policy negotiations with the union were not complete, according to the AP. It also comes just 1 week after the DOJ revealed the BOP director, will be resigning from his post. He had faced criticism during his time as chief of the Bureau. That's it. That's on sharenewsbreak.com. So, yeah. And that's where we're going. That's what we're saying. So, if you want to read the article over, you can find it at sharenewsbreak.com if you want to read more about it. And it says, Olympic medalist. Oh, shit. We have to go to the next one. Okay, this is another death, unfortunately. Olympic medalist Dion Lindor dies at age 29. Rest in peace. My condolences to his family. May he lay in peace for the rest of his life, for eternity. Lindor competed for Trinidad and Tobago at the Tokyo Olympics last year. Dion Lindor, an Olympic and world champion medalist from Trinidad and Tobago, died in a car accident in Texas on Monday. He was 29. According to Texas A&M University, for whom Lindor had worked as a volunteer assistant coach over the past two seasons, the sprinter was returning home from the practice when he was involved in an automobile accident. Lindor competed at three Olympic Games and ran the anchor leg of the men's 40x400 relay final at the 2012 Olympics in London, and his country won bronze. He won silver in the same event at the 2015 World Championship in Beijing before claiming individual bronze medals in the 400 to the 2016 and 2018 World Indoor Championships. Words cannot adequately express our sadness at the devastating and ultimately loss of three-time Olympic and World Championship bronze medalist DeAndre, who have been inspiration and motivation to us all, both on a sick off-track said a statement from the Trinidad and Tobago Olympic Committee. Dion has flown the Trinidad and Tobago flown with pride, honor, patriotism, and the indomitable with throughout his career with helping and inspiring many. Lindor competed at his third Olympics in Tokyo last year, placing eighth with Trinidad and Tobago in the 4x4 finale and reaching the 400 semifinals. He also finished third in the 400 final, the Diamond League in Zurich last September. Visit CNN Sports for more news, video, and features. He was training as a professional athlete under contract with Puma while serving as a volunteer assistant coach in Texas. We are deeply saddened by the passing of Dion Lindor, who had been part of the Puma family since 2017, said a statement from the sportswear company. We are honored that he had chosen to be hit by his side for a large part of his successful track and field career. Our thoughts are with his family. Rest in peace, Dion. In a statement sent to CNN, the Texas Department of Public Safety and three vehicles were involved in the collision in Milliam County and that the investigation is still active and open. Lindor was pronounced dead at the scene while another driver was transported to a medical center for incapacitating injuries. If you want to read more or you want to read this yourself, this is also on sharenewsbreak.com. And we have another death to talk about. Like I said, condolences to his family. May he rest in power and lay in peace forever. And the last one is, this is Tampa Bay Rays bullpen catcher John Ramirez dies at 28. Tampa Bay Rays bullpen catcher and former minor league player Jean Ramirez died on Tuesday at the age of 28, the team announced. No cause of death was given. A 28th round draft pick out of Illinois State in 2016, Ramirez played three seasons in the Rays minor league system before becoming the team's bullpen catcher in 2019. He brought so much passion and energy each day to our clubhouse and bullpens, and his love for the Rays and for the baseball was evident to all who interacted with him. Rays manager Kevin Cash said, "He had the biggest heart and most infectious smile. Jean will be deeply missed." The Rays baseball family mourns the loss of the bullpen catcher Jean Ramirez. Ramirez, a native of Puerto Rico, played high school ball in Fort Worth, Texas, before going to College of Arkansas and transferring to Illinois State. A catcher and first baseman in the minors, he hit 175 with 5 homers over 3 seasons in rookie and low ball. However, he was well regarded as a bullpen catcher as the Rays had one of the major top bullpen in each of 3 years within the club. The article originally appeared on U.S. Today. Tampa Bay Ray Bulls catcher Ramirez dies at 28 share. This was shared on Newsbreak.com as well. My condolences to his family. May he rest in, may he lay in peace for the remainder of his, oh my God, I'm not saying that. May he rest in peace. Okay, that's all I'm saying because I'm not saying stuff right. Like, my mind is like, I don't know. It's everywhere. But those were very quick. If you like any of the top things I talk about, please like, comment, subscribe. I have 2 videos I have to post on YouTube today, which is the one from yesterday and this one today. I have to edit them. Editing is a fucking job. Yes, it is. It's a job. But anywho, like, comment, subscribe, thumbs up, thumbs down. Let me know what you think or comment, subscribe, and like. And as always, please recycle and throw away your trash properly. That is it. See you later. Bye.